Right now, we have to go live to Zamfara State, where the state government is flagging off the total renovation, equipping and rehabilitation of the General Hospital Talata Mafara in Talatan Mafara local government area. To stay with us for details there.
اللهم ربنا ظلمنا انفسنا وان لم تغفر لنا ترحمنا لكنا من الخاسرين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد سبحانك ربك رب العزه عما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
Thank you very much, Honorable Commissioner for Religious Affairs. May I invite the Honorable Commissioner for what to give us the welcome address. Distinguished guests, like we have said, Talata Mafara is going to have a hospital today. This is part of the sustainable development agenda of His Excellency Daud Adawal. A kind of development that will give us development now and will guarantee the future of our generations yet unborn. That is the focus of this government.
Okay, thank you. Your Excellency, the Executive Governor of Zamfara State, Dr. Daud Adawal. Your Excellency, the Deputy Governor of Zamfara State, Malam Maliyu Muhyiddin Musa Muhyi. Your Excellency, the former Governor of Sokoto State, Malam Yahya Abdul Karim, the representative of the Honorable Speaker, the Secretary to the Government, the Deputy Chief of Staff, the Grand Kadi, Honorable Commissioners here present, the special advisors to His Excellency here present, security chiefs here present, members of the press, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. It gives me yet another privilege to welcome all of you to this important flag of ceremony for the construction of General Hospital Talata Mafara, which happens to be as a result of the visit His Excellency paid to the hospital barely 3 weeks ago. Let me say at this juncture that His Excellency's transformation agenda is not only on roads construction, as some people are saying. Recently, His Excellency has constituted a task force to look into ways and manners and to identify more than 70 primary healthcare to be reconstructed across the state. This ceremony is all about the flag of ceremony of a reconstruction of a brand new hospital that will house 200 patients, and the contract is to be awarded, or rather has been awarded, for the sum of 2.4 billion. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, at this juncture, I want to welcome you all and pray to Almighty Allah that all of us will live to see to the completion and utilization of this hospital. Thank you very much. You are welcome.
Thank you very much, Honorable Commissioner, for what? At this point, Your Excellency, may I invite the contractor of this project to speak to us in 2 minutes. From what I have is Shamsuddin, the contractor. Maybe it's okay.
Oh. Your Excellency, the Executive Governor of Zamfara State, Dr. Dawud Alawan, all other protocols duly observed, I feel highly honored to stand before you on the occasion of the foundation laying ceremony for the construction of the 200-bed ultra-modern hospital in Talata Mafara. On behalf of AM Nigeria Limited, I wish to sincerely thank His Excellency for giving us the opportunity to be part of this historic and signature project. I wish to inform His Excellency that this hospital has a total and coverage of about 3,500 square meters and has been designed to conform with global best practice in hospital and other health facility design. The hospital has been carefully designed to be patient-friendly, provide for better and easy service delivery, enhance headroom, circulation spaces, natural ventilation and lighting. For effective service delivery, this facility is designed to have a 90 kVA solar system to provide 24 hours uninterrupted power supply. And the hospital is built to be practically completed in 24 weeks. Furthermore, Your Excellency may also wish to note that in addition to administrative spaces and other supporting services obtainable in a standard general hospital such as antenatal and dental clinic, ENT, mammogram, accident and emergency, theater, X-ray, pharmacy and ICU, this hospital, when completed, shall boast of over 200 patient bed spaces that includes male and female surgical and medical wards, amenity, pediatric, as well as labor wards. Your Excellency, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, AIM Nigeria Limited is committed to timely delivery of a qualitative world-class hospital that will stand the test of time and become a resounding legacy of this noble administration and a reference point not just in Zamfara State, but Nigeria in general. Once again, on behalf of AIM Nigeria Limited, I wish to sincerely thank His Excellency for this great opportunity and promise to deliver on this task exceptionally. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Contractor Shamsuddin. I am sure you must have been selected based on your qualities and the trust, and I believe you will justify that to His Excellency and the people of Zamfara State. Your Excellency, muna da minti biyar wanda muka ware ma entertainment. Huskokin da aka saba gani yau ba su za a gani ba. Akwai wasu masoyanka waɗanda ake ce ma aljannun mai gida da kuma wani mai suna Katon mai gida. Na ba su minti biyu domin sun dade suna bin mu garuruwa amma ba su samu mai girma gwamna ya gansu ba. Wani lokaci sukan doki ma kamar MC ne baya son mai girma gwamna ya gansu. Don haka yau na ba ku minti biyu. Basira duk da kuke da ita ku zube ta gure in gani amma cikin minti biyu. gode kwarai mun gode a cika alƙawari a cika alƙawari mun gode kwarai da gaske waɗannan masoyan mu ne da su muke ta yawon campaign tun da aka fara yau dai na ba ku dama kun yi rawa gaban mai girma gwamna Kabiru binnin magaji gwamna lamba 1 At this point, I have the honor to invite our special guest of honor, Malam Yahya Abdul Karim, former governor of Sokoto State, to give a brief remark. Special guest of honor, sir.
The governor of Zamfara State, Dr. Dauda Lawal, Your Excellency, the Deputy Governor, Malam Mani, Mumuni, Masa Mamudi, Mijam Maimuna. The Secretary to the State Government, Honorable Commissioners, Right Honorable Speaker, members of State House Assembly, Traditional Rulers, members of press, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Well, I want to correct the MC and the other people who identified me as the governor, a former governor of Sokoto State. I'm former governor of former Sokoto State because Talata, Mafara, and Busau were all local government under my administration. So I should be identified as such. This is part of my former administration. May I congratulate Your Excellency for making it possible to let people of Latimovra have a complete new hospital. The Latimovra Hospital was constructed some 52 years ago, 1972 to be precise. Since then, it has gone under partial renovation and so on and so forth. The situation has become so much deteriorated because of lack of continuous maintenance. When I was invited, I was told that the Latimovra Hospital was going to be renovated. But now I understand that complete new hospital is going to be given to the people of Latimovra, and within the next few months, I asked the governor, I said, the construction is not a problem. What about the equipment? Because the equipment are more costly than the structure. He told me that he has already made the equipment available for this hospital. This is a very, very good information, which means that in the next few months, the people of Latimovra may have a good, new, equipped hospital. So I congratulate the governor. I also congratulate the people of Latimovra for having this development. Your people, you should know that the government is about a few things, but the three are the most important. One, the security. Number two, food. Number three, health. When you get this, you get everything. Because the rest of the thing, whether the government provided or not, you will make your effort to provide them for yourself. So I congratulate the governor for giving the people health now. And I'm sure something is being done to take care of the security. Looking at the farms when I'm coming in, I found that the Damana was so promising because there are a lot of food in the field. So I'm sure next year will be better than this year. The question of hunger and the health and security will go. So I promise the people. So since you know that the house. So Jama Talatumovra na fara da ba MC Query na cewa ni gwamnatin da nayi na tsohon Sokoto state nayi ba na Sokoto state yanzu ba domin Talatumovra da kuso duk local government ne karfi wasu daga cikin wannan nake gani ko su duk lokacin ba shi su ba da nake gwamna shekara 30 da uku da ce sun ka wuce so ina tabbata muku cewa lokacin da aka gina wannan asibiti yau shekara 52 1972 aka yi ta kuma tun lokacin ta shiga hannuwa da yawa har ta kai lokacin da ba ta gyaruwa domin ginin da kayayyakin abubuwa da sun yi kasa shi yasa gwamna da ya zo ya duba ya ga cewa kamata ya gyara ta ba gyara ni na tsammanin gyara za a yi ashe sabon asibiti za a bamu sabon asibiti complete kuma na ce mai to kayan aiki ba domin ka gina asibiti baka da kaya wai shi ai na samu kayan suna nan na ajiye saboda haka wato ƴan watanni kaɗan mutanen Latimovra ba sai kun je Gusau ko Sokoto neman lahiya ba in Allah ya so nan za ku tsaya ba za ku kashe kuɗinku ba za ku yi taya nesa ba za ku tsaya asibitinku wanda an kai muku wanda ke da kaya kuma na tabbatar da cewa akwai likitoci na ƙwarai za a kawo muku wanda yake ba sai ka yi dogon tafiya ba jama'a ina son in ɗauki wannan lokaci in gode ma gwamna na tunanin gina asibiti sabuwa a Latimovra. Ina fatar Allah Ubangiji ya sa mutanen Latin fara su amfana bayan an gama wannan asibiti.
Amin.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi
wa barakatuh.
Your Excellency, muna ba da hakuri tuntuban harshen da muka yi da karancin shekaru lokacin da kake governor. Amma yanzu mun dibi ilimi mun kuma gane yadda zamu rika kiran ka duk inda muka ganka insha Allah muna godiya.
Mala kai gwamnati kai minista. Mala hayatul karimu dan dattijo. Sauda, ka tafi na sarki aiki.
Distinguished personalities, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time to invite the health master, the road master, the security master. It is time to invite His Excellency, the Executive Governor, Zamfara State, Dauda Lawal, our every leader. The executive Zamfara State, Dauda Lawal, to the podium. Your Excellency, sir.
Sokoto State, Mala Yahya Abdul Karim, representative of the Honorable Speaker, our party chairman and members of the State Working Committee, Secretary to the Government, Head of Service, Honorable Commissioners and Advisors, members of our security outfit that are here with us, our elder, Ma Alai Salome Buhugumi, and other elders that are here with us, our invited guests, gentlemen of the press, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum. Let me start by expressing our heartfelt gratitude to our esteemed leader, Malam Yahya Abdul Karim, MNI, Maga General Rafin Sokoto, former governor of Old Sokoto State, for honoring our invitation to serve as the special guest of honor at this event. Your presence here at the flag off of the construction and equipment of 200-bed capacity General Hospital in Talata Mafra underscores your unwavering dedication to the development of our dear state. We are deeply honored to have such a distinguished elder statesman among us as we hold this groundbreaking ceremony. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you with good health and continuous wisdom to serve the state and the nation. By the will of Allah, I'm here today to fulfill the promise I made a few months ago when I visited this hospital and the State University. Considering the sorry state of this health facility, I pledge to undertake its total reconstruction in order to provide a befitting general hospital for an expanding commercial town like Talata Mafara. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, this administration has prioritized the revitalization of decaying infrastructure as a critical pillar of our transformational agenda. We have deliberately placed education and healthcare at the forefront, recognizing their central roles in the societal development. This hospital is just one of the many facilities being constructed to provide a conducive environment for delivering quality healthcare services. Our administration remains steadfast in its commitment to investing in the healthcare sector, with a clear understanding of the crucial role that General Hospital plays in the healthcare delivery system. They serve as a vital link between primary healthcare facilities and tertiary institutions. The project we are flagging up today involves the construction of 200-bed capacity hospital and providing modern equipment to improve service delivery to the entire people of Talata Mafra, as well as the immediate environment. This includes the construction of the following facilities: reception and waiting rooms, records and account section, pediatric wards, male medical wards, male surgical wards, laboratory, theater, dental lab, pharmacy, female surgical wards, female medical wards, ENT department, two labor rooms with an in-charge office, treatment rooms, nurses station, CMD office with the secretary's office, dentist office, female changing room, five consulting rooms, ICU, X-ray units, preparation room, recovery room, pharmacy, mammogram unit, accident and emergency AE unit, office, doctors on call room, antenatal ward, restaurant with kitchen, two-bed wards, and a matron's room. It will be completed within 6 months, inshallah. At this juncture, it is my singular honor and privilege to invite our special guest of honor, His Excellency, the former governor of Old Sokoto State, Malam Yahaya Abdulkareem, MNI, Magajin Rafin Sokoto, to flag off the construction of this hospital officially. Inshallah, we will do our utmost to achieve Sustainable Development Goal 3, which aims to ensure healthy lives and promote well-being for all ages. Focus on universal health coverage and access to safe, adequate quality and affordable medicines and vaccinations. May Allah ease our mission to realize our aspiration for a better Zamfara State. And I thank you all for finding the time to be with us today. May Allah continue to guide us and make sure we deliver the dividend of democracy to the entire people of Zamfara State, inshallah. Jama'a, assalamu alaikum. Kamar yadda kuka gani, idan za ku iya tunawa 'yan watanni uku da suka wuce, na ziyarci Talatin Mafara na zo wannan asibiti kuma na duba halin da asibitin take ciki a lokacin nan wanda a lokacin ne alƙawarin akan cewa da ikon Allah zan gina ma al'ummar talatin mafara sabon asibiti to alhamdulillah yau mun cika maka wannan alƙawari kamar yanda ne wannan alƙawari saboda haka jama'ar talatin mafara nan da wata shida masu zuwa da izinin Allah ba sai kun je Sokoto ko Gusau ko Katsina ko wani wuri neman lafiya kamar yanda babban bakonmu ya faɗa ya tambaye ni akan cewa wata shida shin za mu iya gina asibitin nan kuma mu kawo annan na'urori sai na bashi tabbacin cewa tun ma kafin mu gina bafin mu design mun riga mun so wannan na'urori kuma suna ƙasa kuma shi wannan contractor mun tabbatar mashi da cewa kudin aikin nan suna ƙasa saboda haka babu wani dalili da zai sa aikin nan an fara ya tsaya in kun ga an tsaya to watakila bai kai kwalitin da muke magana ba wanda dole in an yi ba daidai ba sai mun tabbata cewa an yi daidai saboda haka muna ƙara godiya ga irin karanci da ƙauna da ake nuna mana duk da haka ina ƙara roƙon al'umma muna bara addu'a da irin matsalolin da muke ciki na tsaro da makamantansu na imani gwamnati na bakin ƙoƙarinta kuma Allah ya sani Allah ya san zukatanmu ba mu zo don mu yaudari kowa ba ba mu zo don mu yi ma kowa ƙarya ba mun zo duk abin da muka ce za mu yi da ikon Allah za mu yi shi yasa ba ma furta idan mun san cewa ba za mu yi ba saboda haka gwamnati tana bara addu'a alhamdulillah muna samun sauki a wajen matsalar tsaro ga jami'an tsaronmu nan suna nan ko ina dare da rana suna bakin ƙoƙarinsu Allah ya taimake su Allah ya taimake mu baki ɗaya kuma na ƙara addu'a cewa ku tashi da addu'a cewa duk wani wanda yake da hannu wajen cutata mu al'ummar jihar Zamfara da Najeriya Ubangiji Allah ka san shi ka san kuma zukatanmu Allah ka bi ma al'umma haƙƙinsu Allah ka tona musu asiri ko ina suke Allah ya sa duk abin da za su samu ya zamanto masifa ce a gare su da iyalansu saboda haka addu'a tana da muhimmanci a ci gaba da addu'a Allah ya fi mu sanin waɗannan matsaloli kuma ya san ko su ake ciki wanda mu ba san su ba amma Allah zai mana maganin su insha Allah saboda haka muna ƙara godiya Allah ya saka da alheri assalamu alaikum
yanzu kuma mai girma yanzu mace a sakoto
Bismillah. It's okay?
To enable us.
It's okay, they got it. It's okay.
Distinguished guest, wherever you are watching us from, you can see His Excellency alongside the former governor of the former Sokoto State laying the foundation for the construction of this hospital. We thank Almighty Allah for this day.
Imani bai tausayi wanda bai jira fasashin daura ba don kudi kake gwamna ba
in the name of Allah merciful
okay
in kaddama da yin wannan asibiti lazum bakarin lazum bakara wanda za ta taimaka ma al'ummar da lazum bakara ina roƙon Allah taimaka mana mutanen lazum bakara su amfana da wannan wannan niyya ta gona wanda yayi ta taimaka mutanen bakura da mutanen bakura za ma ai
mutanen
bakura ta samu
da mutanen bakura
har ta samu bakura ta samu Allah ya kare mu
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. With this, His Excellency is at the
magana za mu ranga yi a ranga zuwa duba aiki wallahi
akwai macuta ba
kina da
akwai macuta
magana
Allah
shi ne a taki shi a yi kokari a gama
medical ward, then we have the female surgical ward, we have the pediatric ward here, we have the medical ward around here.
Yeah, okay, Mike.
Here we have the male surgical ward, this is the male surgical ward, this is the male medical ward. Then we have the ANC clinic around here. These are the specialist areas where we have the ENT, the ICU, the X-ray, we have the theater, we have the restaurant and the kitchen. We have the restaurant and the kitchen. Then we have the mammogram, we have the CMD's office and the secretary's office around here. Then this is the reception. These are the waiting areas. We have the record. We have the pharmacy somewhere there. And we have the accident and emergency unit here. We have a laboratory. We have general labs around here. Now this is the 3D aerial view of the hospital. When completed, it's going to look like this. And we have about 200 visitors and patients as well. This is a typical ward. This is how it's going to look like at the end of the construction work. This is a typical lab where tests will be carried out. That is a single story, and it's about 3,500 square meters. It's a very large hospital, compact with better circulation spaces, better headrooms, better ventilation and lighting. Excellent.
Thank you very much. As you can see, distinguished guest, His Excellency will now address the press on this.
Akwai Ministry of Works, akwai Commissioner Project Implementation.
Distinguished guests, please.
Okay, yeah, Your Excellency, you okay. Are you set? Are you there?
Your Excellency, this is a 200-bed hospital, and the flag of this construction of this hospital is today. When should the people of Zamfara State look forward to the completion of this project?
If you had listened to my speech, I said the construction period is 6 months to completion. And we'll make sure we maintain that timeline given to the contractor.
Sir, almost everybody is satisfied and confident that you are doing everything you can to ensure that infrastructure is being put in place in the health sector. What about manpower?
Well, the two actually go together. While we are doing everything now to provide the necessary infrastructure in place, especially in hospital, and remember, in November last year, I declared a state of emergency in the health sector. And what we did since then is to make sure we train people, especially nurses. And what we're doing right now also is to look for medical personnel, even at a premium, and it's ongoing. So before we finish this construction, I will assure you that we will have the required manpower to man not just this hospital, but other hospitals that are under construction.
How many are your targets, sir?
Well, right now, we have done Karanamoda, we have done Nasaram Burkulu, and in the next 2-3 hours, we are going to commission that of Maru. We are going to do Safi. Yerimambakura Special Hospital is also undergoing the same process construction and providing total new equipment for the healthcare sector. So it's an ongoing thing.
Excellency, you just seen the building plan. Are you satisfied with it? And do you think this will make a difference?
Even before we issued the contract, I look at the design from day one. I look at the 3D, and it was on that basis we approved the construction. It's not the first time I'm seeing this, but this is just for public.
What about the old site? Are we expecting renovation and upgrade of the old site?
Well, it all depends. Right now, we are doing a new construction right now, and we don't want to disrupt anything that is happening there in terms of the patient. So by the time we finish, that is when we'll determine whether we just lay everything down or bring everything down, or if there's a need for those that can be reconstructed, we will do that. It is something that we will consider before they finish this particular one.
Any special arrangement for pregnant women and children?
Of course, everybody is involved. If you had listened to my speech, there is female wards, female surgical, female medical.
I mean, in terms of full medical service?
No. Of course, it's going to be everybody. Everybody, not just female. But of course, emphasis will be given to female. But everybody will have free medical care in Zamfara State. We've started, and it's ongoing, and we'll continue to do that until we get to the target that is acceptable.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We are done with the interview.
What we are going to witness here today, as we move straight away to Maru to witness yet another activity that is of official benefit to our people in Zamfara State. Thank you so much, Your Excellency, for being a very good leader. Thank you.
To Abuda, Abada hadin kai ayi biyayya.
Allah,